I'm sorry if this video is rushed. It really is. Forgive me this time. Okay. Hey guys, okay, so I'm gonna keep it real. I did not vlog yesterday. I spent time with my family. It was so amazing, just so nice. But I figured, okay, I literally have like 10 minutes. I'm not even kidding. I have to go to my parents' house right now. So 2021 is upon us. A lot of you are into journaling. I love journaling. So I thought I would do a really quick video just sharing with you. Literally my Natalie's Outlet must have stationery products for bullet journaling. Things that are just inspiring, creative, absolutely beautiful. And I will link everything down below in my Amazon shop. I'm sorry if this video is rushed. It really is. But if you'd like to see this be a little bit more in depth, I can do that for you guys next time. But please forgive me this time. Okay. Taking a look at all of my beautiful stationery stuff. Ding, 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 ding. Ooh, child. Okay, this is my happy place. As I've told you guys many, many times, I love to keep all of my stationery stuff where you could see it. That's like my number one tip because that way you actually use it. Okay. So the very first thing I recommend is one of these journals. First of all, it is gorgeous, holographic. Ooh, you are looking at yourself right now. By the way, these are being sent to the giveaway winners. Thank you for everyone who said that they wanted this. Some people thought this was an egg. I get it. I see it now. And then my little Relakum one. So cute. So this is being sent to two lucky people. So this journal has been my absolute go-to. First of all, you can get this off Amazon. It is dirt cheap. What I love about it is not only is it gorgeous, it is the perfect size. The A5 style is absolutely incredible. It doesn't weigh a lot. You can put it in your purse. Kind of, not really. You can put it in your backpack. It's like very just compact. Take it to the cafe, do your journaling, whatever you want. And what's really cool and what I like this more for is because of this, the little binder. So if you make a mistake and you don't like what you did, just take it out. That's it. These are insertable worksheets. I will also link down below. I personally prefer the dotted ones just like this. These are my 2020 goals that never got done. We all know what happened. And I love these. Also, one thing that I noticed, and Moleskine actually does this, is these pages are not that white. So if you like white pages, then just know these are like a little bit of cream pages. But the reason that Moleskine does this is because whenever you look at a white paper, it's actually scientifically proven that it makes you go blank. And so having a little cream paper allows you to flow a little bit better. At least that's what I find. So this is my bullet journal. I've showed you guys a million bajillion times all of these pages. Ooh, these are some new ones that I did. Super fun, but whatever. So highly recommend this. It's super awesome, very cheap, and I will link it down below. Second essential are my one and only midliners. These are the bomb.com. Let me just tell you, first of all, they're pastel colors. They look gorgeous. Second of all, they allow you to create just beautiful theme of just pastel colors. Kind of like these pages, as you could see. I literally just use these. Oh wait, no. I'm actually lying to you. Hold up, honey. My bad. I got a little mixed up. These I really recommend. They look gorgeous for just like highlighting titles, headliners, absolutely everything. And one thing that I didn't know about these, first of all, this is what they look like. Midliners, you could get these at Target. They have one end, which is a little bit thicker. And then they have the other end, which is fine. I will tell you, I barely use this one, but I still like the option of both. My other absolute favorite must-haves are Pilot Friction Highlighter. These are the pastel colors, obviously. Your girl loves pastel. I can't find my pink, but these colors, if you just want anything for your bullet journal to always look cohesive and aesthetic, just get these pastel colors. The thing that I recommend the most is to always just use the same colors per page, so that way everything looks more uniformed, if you're into that. If not, go crazy, girl. It's okay. And the really cool thing about these also is they are erasable. It can't get better than that. It just can't. Some examples of places that I have used the colors together. That's one. As you can see, I use them here to line that. Look at this one. Look much more cohesive. It's really that simple. My other recommendation, a lot of you are like, Natalie, how do you get your ideas? Like, what do you do to get inspired to make your page look cute? Stickers. You can't go wrong. If you don't know how to draw, if you don't know how to highlight, if you don't know how to do a straight line, whatever, stickers are your best friend. Also, I would just say like pretty stationery. Like literally I found this. This is kind of bland. It's pretty basic. Has a bunch of beautiful quotes, but just adding stickers around it, washi tape will go a long, long way. One thing that I'm doing this Christmas is I'm actually gifting myself some stationery boxes. So I will link some down below in case you are interested to know what. These are some other little stationery papers, just anything that can make your pages look that much cuter. Of course, stickers. These I literally got at Five Below for, I think it was $2. And there's so many in here. So cute. Some more cute stationery, very kawaii. You know, I'm obsessed with that kind of stuff. stuff. And then just stickers, go ham. You can get these at Target. They have the prettiest of stuff. You can do so much with it. And I personally just really like having different theme stickers. I recently purchased some new ones. I gotta show you, okay? So that, like, for instance, this is all about vacation. So if you're doing a spread all about your vacation or your dreams to go somewhere, you could use that. You don't have to get too crazy. A girl's night, as you can see. This one has so many different things. It has like who to call, work life, rent, pretty much anything and everything that you want. Love these. I got this one at Target, but I also buy a lot of my stuff over at Michael's. It's a little pricey, but always great quality. What do we have here? We have the washi tapes. I bought this at Muji, and these things are the freaking best. Alongside this one and alongside this one, it's just the best way to keep all of your stuff organized. So for bullet journaling, you definitely need washi tape. And let me just get you onto these. These are by my friend Amanda Rach Lee, as you can see. This is her entire collection. Thank you, Amanda, for sending me this. You are the bullet journal queen. Using washi tape for your bullet journal just takes everything to the next level. Also, what I really like about these is they're tacky enough to stick, but you can also remove them without ruining your page in case you change your mind later down the line. Post-its. Look, it's simple, it's aesthetic, the colors are just all there. Sometimes I just take some, layer them all over the page. Whenever I make a mistake, I just pop one in, put some washi tape around it. These are your best friends, I'm just saying. Ooh, can you see how everything's just getting more and more messy? Another thing I recommend, if you are not an artist or don't know what to do, is to get really cute books with really pretty aesthetic imagery or writing. This is one of my favorites. It's so cute and compact. This is by Adam J. Kurtz. It's called Things Are What You Make of Them, Life Advice for Creatives. It's super cute and makes every single page look that much cuter. And what's really nice is you can actually rip it out really nicely. The details in this is amazing. You can actually rip it off and put it in your bullet journal. Here's another one that I love, and I just take some like imagery. Sometimes I even just like copy it over, whatever I want. There's no rules to bullet journaling, okay? What else? All right, I'm trying to like look around and see what other stuff I recommend. Do not judge me for this next thing. I know, this is ridiculous. Okay, these are my jam. This is what you use instead of glue or instead of, you know, sticky, tacky stuff. This is pretty much glue tape. So how it works is, do you see that? So it's super simple. It's tacky like this, and then you just spread it across a piece of paper. You can barely see it, honestly. Do you see what it looks like? It doesn't make any of your papers like bumpy or bubbly. And then you just stick whatever you want on top, and it is really good. Ideal for bullet journaling. Highly recommend. You can buy these anywhere. Michael's, Target, different styles. I will link my favorite down below. Other things that I recommend. Okay, these are just like extra little things. Oh, it's actually over here. This thing is thebomb.com. It's this little machine that you can pretty much write whatever you want and stick it. It's actually a label machine. I wonder if I have any labels around here. Not today, Satan, I guess. But I usually label like my little like things in my closet, and you can also just label, you can also just use this to label really cute pages in your bullet journal. Absolutely love it. This guy over here is the best. Okay, it's just a best. I find that what I love about bullet journaling is that you get to take anything that's been in your phone, kind of just put it on paper. And so here you get to print out pictures from your phone. Really cute. I've done this in the past for different bullet journals, and and I'll link my bullet journal videos down below so you can check it out. But pretty much you just get really cute compact Polaroids. This is a little pricey, but if you want to just spice up your bullet journal, highly recommend. And then I will just finalize with this. These are some art books. Oh my god, it's all falling. These are just some art books, and I get so much inspiration from them. Like for instance, this one, this is the Kawaii Doodle class book. Also bought this at Five Below. It's absolutely adorable. And I use this to inspire a little spread that I did here in my bullet journal. I wouldn't even say this is really like a bullet journal. Oh, there you see it. Oh, look at how cute. See how the washi tape just goes a really long way? This is the one. So literally just took some of the images here and then just did my own thing right over here, and it just makes for a lot of fun. All right, literally my dad is outside. I'm starting to get nervous. One more, actually two more things. Okay, here are some other books that I absolutely love. This is A Book That Takes Its Time by Flo. These are some paper books. Amazing. Everything's just falling. This is why I love this. Like, if you're a paper lover, this is for you. Look at how many different styles of paper, ideas, and things you have here. Literally, if you are the most non-creative person, or you just don't know how to really like lay out a page, this will do it for you. Just get creative, have fun, let loose like a goose. Whew, I'm out of breath. And to finalize, if you're interested in any inspiration for your bullet journal for 2021, I will leave a playlist of all of the videos that I've done, calligraphy, bullet journal, and I will also leave my Amazon favorites so that you can literally just put it in your cart and get it tomorrow. So that is what's up. My family is here. I'm so sorry if this was so rushed, but I just wanted to do this for you, and I also wanted to be with my family. So I love you guys, and I will see you in the next vlog.